What is up, everyone? Welcome to the first vlog with my new camera, this little Sony awesome thing that Christian donated, as you saw last week in the bonus video, the unboxing. It is Tuesday today, not the Tuesday that you're watching this on. It is the Tuesday on my week off, so that's pretty cool. I promised that I was going to vlog the whole week, and I am vlogging the whole week, everything except for yesterday. Started recording a vlog on my Fuji camera and decided that I would start recording on this camera today instead. So bear with me as I am getting used to it, and I don't always know when it's recording. There's a record light on the back. I've got low battery in it at the moment because I thought it was charging and it wasn't, so I'll have to charge it up in a bit, so there will be a delay in clips. But it is Tuesday the 2nd, I believe it is. It's about 4:10. I've had a full day of doing bits and bobs. Today is when I filmed the unboxing of this camera. I'm so pleased with it, guys. I think it's really, really cool. It's just such a cool little camera. Let me show you guys what I'm doing today. So I've done all sorts of bits and bobs today, but at the moment I'm currently in the studio, as you guys can see. I'm actually fiddling around with this Phonic desk. The desk that I use for live. I've just got a mic and a DI and stuff going in just to remind myself, because I haven't used it for a long time. I've been using an Allen & Heath QU24. I've probably got some dates coming up where I'll be using this desk, so I'm just reminding myself of a few bits and bobs on it, which is always a good thing to do. This desk, you know, by today's standards, maybe not the greatest, but I still get on with it really well. It's a bit laggy around the menus and stuff, but apart from that, I really like it, and it's got very clean preamps. It's a nice desk. So I'm just using my studio monitors to monitor with, basically, going in on the first couple of channels. But yeah, I've been fiddling around with this for about an hour, and I was waiting for the camera to charge, and it wasn't charging, so, you know, I'll figure that out. But I am going to be sort of hot on watching my videos, previewing the clips from this camera, just to make sure I'm not making any drastic mistakes. I'm not sure. I think I'm recording in 1080. I haven't quite figured it out yet, but the best way for us to figure it out is just to go for it. So I'm really excited to vlog with this all week. And this week, as you guys know, week off, it's going to be a little bit different to my usual weeks. Today I've got a few things on the list, nothing drastic. My week has actually turned around. I did state in the I'm taking a week off video that today I'd be rigging and programming lighting, but that has moved to tomorrow, and the studio session has moved to Thursday, so now today, Tuesday, has been free for me. And I've been enjoying myself. I did the unboxing of this camera and did a few bits and bobs, you know, not working too hard or anything. But what I'm going to do now is power everything down and up here and go downstairs. Now, one thing I can't remember how to do is shut down this desk. What I'll do is turn all the gains down. I can't believe I've forgotten how to do that. Let's move my iPad out of the way just in case the faders start flying around. One other downside to this desk is it's quite slow to start up and shut down and stuff, and it can be a little problematic. So what I always do is run it through a smaller analog desk as well, just to get the party started if I have to wait for this thing to boot up. Where am I still getting? I'm still getting signal from somewhere. It's okay. I shall also turn this lot off before turning that desk off. Oh, my panning was a bit off there. Turn that off. Bye-bye to the speakers. You can see those. They've just powered off. Turn the power conditioner off. Turn the desk off. Power switch over here. Perfect. Turn all these off. This is just my iPad charger. Oh gosh. Okay, and now let's figure out how to turn this off.
Whatever, I got a bit confused. I don't even know if you have to shut that desk down properly. But anyway, got my iPad. Let's go back down. We'll be coming up a little bit later because I got some stuff to drop off here. I've got to plug this camera in. It's complaining at me that I've got low battery. So I haven't delved into this camera settings at all, guys. You know, no Wi-Fi, nothing at all yet. But that will all come in good time. I look forward to doing it. Yeah, I think I better get this on charge. So guys, armed with a bit more battery, what is the time? And I've just had a little look at the clips that I recorded earlier. Very, very pleased with this camera. 6:05. And I am currently fiddling with my Hackintosh. So check it out. Here it is. As you guys can see, I'm on a fresh install screen. Now, It's going fairly well. I'm reinstalling for a couple of different reasons. I still haven't got my optimal workflow and settings worked out. I am struggling a little bit with the 960, but I've ditched the RAID 0 now. But of course, you guys will have got the full update about this in part 5. This was half of the reason why I couldn't upload part 5 for so long. You know, I was just working on the Hackintosh for ages and ages. But I'm getting there. I've got to go through this and then I'll give you a little bit of a better vlog update. It's not for the faint-hearted, this, guys. It's certainly not for the faint-hearted. Anything slightly out of the ordinary and you will be battling with multiple guides, instructions, trying to grasp what you can from various sources. Yeah, it's a little bit of a struggle, but it's worth it. You save so much money, you get a custom build. It really is worth it. I can only do very short sessions at a time because I lose patience with it very, very quickly. Still working on my Hackintosh, guys. It's a tricky process. It is a tricky process. You know, to anyone that says, oh, it's really easy, it hasn't been plain sailing for me, but, you know, I didn't help myself at all. If I hadn't had that whole RAID 0 fiasco, then it would be fine. I'm still gutted that I couldn't get that working, but as I say, you guys will have seen part 5 by now, so it's pretty, you know, it's pretty useless me chatting about it now, but I guess that's the danger of vlogging on a long expanse of time. Sometimes the time frames can get messed up a bit, because at the moment, you know, I haven't finished part 5, so I don't really know what I'm going to be talking about and stuff. But anyway, it seems to be going all right now. I've actually started using a couple of post-it notes for just to help me organise myself, really, just so that I can get the satisfaction of, like, ripping them off the screen, scrumpling them up and throwing them in the bin, because I think that would be pretty cool. It'll make me feel good once I've achieved some tasks. But other than that, just chilling, really pleased with the reception on my video in terms of people accepting my week off. I think that's really cool. And of course, got the old instructions open from various people there, loads of different tabs of different methods that people are doing with their Hackintoshes, but here I am in Multibeast. I spend a lot of my time here. Alright guys, you join me in a very exciting moment. It is a lot later. It is around 20 to 9 and I have finally got my Hackintosh up and running the way I want it. And you can even see I've installed most of my applications. So things are going really, really well. But what I'm going to do now is shut down both the Hackintosh and my Mac Pro. I've closed all of the applications. Reason I'm doing this is because I am going to give the Hackintosh a whirl on my main setup, which is very exciting. I'm going to use it with DVI on all three displays. Obviously one being HDMI to DVI, which is so exciting. I can't wait to try this out. I will update you guys when I've got the Hackintosh on there. Okay, so I've had to completely remove the Mac Pro off the setup. It's going to have to go back on because I've got unfinished projects on this machine this week, but hopefully they'll all be resolved this week so that next week I can start using the Hackintosh on the main setup if everything goes okay. But I don't want to speak too soon. I've got everything plugged in. The hanging VGA is because I'm using two DVIs, as you can see, with a HDMI there for the third monitor that's going to DVI. And I haven't got my FireWire plugged in because I've got my FireWire card yanked out currently, just because I was troubleshooting when I was installing. But let's switch that on. Ooh, actually, I switched that off. Switch that on. Power on the machine. Hang on a sec. There we go. Turns out it was on. I do have a problem with my LEDs as well, guys, but that's the least of my concern right now. Let's take a look at what it does. Okay, center display, that is a good start. A very good start. There it is. Apple logo. And I'll need to change the input of this monitor to DVI. Let's see what it does. Oh yes, three screens. Let me put in my password. Hang on, let me lay down the camera. And if we pull up, you guys will be able to see that we have triple display action from this Hackintosh. That is such a brilliant, brilliant sight. I'm so happy. Let's open some applications. Well guys, I'm running my Hackintosh. Everything is going really well at the moment. I'm having a chat to Christian. We're just chatting about Hackintoshes and stuff because he's thinking of doing one, and I'm just telling him how it's going and stuff. This is a massive step forward, guys. Just to basically explain, I have not had this system running on my setup yet, so this is a massive, massive step forward for me, and it is really cool. I'm only playing around with it. I'll have to yank it out and put my Mac Pro back, but yeah, it's really, really cool for the moment. I'm thoroughly enjoying myself.
Well, guys, I now have my little Sony camera in its protective casing, and it's getting to nighttime, so we'll see if there's a decrease in quality. Don't know if you'll be able to hear it in the background, but I'm listening to the Rayman soundtrack. I'm just about to get picked up, and I'm going to Jess's house. We're going to chill out. I don't know what we're going to do, actually. Maybe play some Mario Kart. We've been loving the Mario Kart lately. But yeah, I will try and continue to vlog, because I'm going to take my camera with me, and I'll see what clips I get tomorrow morning and stuff. I've got to leave early tomorrow morning to go to work, because tomorrow is my day of rigging up and stuff, so that'll be really cool. And of course I can take the camera tomorrow, so that's great.
It's absolutely amazing. I love it. I just need to sort out my LEDs. It's very uneven on this side, and obviously sort out the power button and stuff, but that'll be all sorted very soon.
It's nice to have the Hackintosh smoothly shutting down, just like a real Mac. No sight of any of that PC stuff. Here we go. Just got to power down now. Any second. A couple of little kinks to iron out. Nothing major. And it's off. Excellent. Oh, guys, it's so good to have this up and running. I've needed this time for ages just to figure things out, you know, just to figure out how to get it up and running and stuff. Really looking forward to seeing how this little Sony camera does in low light. I've got my own little vlogging camera. It's so cool. It's even got a little tripod attachment. Sorry, guys, I'm getting distracted. Because I'm using it in the case now, so I could use my stick, but the stick makes it a lot bigger, and it's absolutely fine holding it anyway, and I can use both hands, so that's all good. Anyway, time for me to hit the road, as they say. How does it do in total darkness? I guess we'll find out.
Speeding, caught on camera.
So everyone, it's Wednesday morning, it's about 5 to 8. Actually, let me double check the time. Nice bus journey this morning. Thought it was going to be, oh no, it's 8:05. Thought it was going to be tipping down with rain. Let's boot up the Hackintosh, see what it does this morning. Thought it was going to be tipping down with rain, because it was yesterday, but it was quite sunny. In fact, as you saw, it was pretty much really good weather, but it is going over a little grey now. I'm being picked up for work around 9 o'clock, so I want to ditch this beard before I go. Oh man, I will be taking my camera with me. Don't know how much sort of talking to the camera vlogging I'll be doing, but hopefully a fair bit. Not a fair bit, but show you a fair bit. Anyway, sorry guys, I haven't fully woken up yet.
So everyone, it's still Wednesday. Apologies, I was so tired this morning, man. I've had a bit of a turn of events. It is the afternoon. The electrical work that was being carried out in work was still being carried out today. So it turns out that I could not rig up and test lighting. So that has now been rescheduled for next week. So that's a big change right there. So it is now the afternoon, but it's good because I've gained an afternoon, which is great. It's 20 to 2 and I haven't got to go back to work until 6. So I get a nice bit of time to do stuff now. The only slightly annoying factor is, I hate it when this kind of thing happens. Basically, on our main street, we had a gas main put in not too long ago. because our village doesn't have mains gas, and it does now. You know, and everything was going great. And now, because everyone's been getting stems off from that main supply, the road is very uneven. So they're resurfacing the road. You know, it needs to be done. It's pretty much essential because the road is in horrendous condition. But they're doing it now. And my God, is it chaos out there. They're not quite directly in front of my house at the moment. I'll actually show you now. So bear with me, folks. Obviously, I'm still getting used to this camera, so I don't quite know, you know, positioning and whatnot yet. But as you can see, they've already started sort of digging, and you've got little cones there, and it says those signs, those yellow signs on the cones, say no pedestrian access. Now I just walked up the pavement because I came back from work. I walked up the pavement and I walked past like four or five workmen, and they all just sort of nodded and said all right. So I guess I was allowed to walk there, but I assume those signs are there just ready for when you're not allowed to walk there. But then I'm thinking, well, if you can't walk on the damn pavement, where do you walk, you know? So, it's a little bit odd, but, yeah.
So, I don't know how long it's going to take. They're resurfacing the whole road. I don't think they're resurfacing the pavements. They've recently been done. Having said that, the gas mains have been going through the pavements as well, so, they've been dug up. So, I have no idea how long it's going to take. I just know that it's going to be loud. I'm just glad I got a double glazed window in the front here, because it blocks out the majority of the noise, but, at least I'm not recording video as they speak, just my vlog. Oh, it's all happening already, look.
You know, lorries and everything reversing. It's going to be this for ages now. Christ, that front tyre of that lorry looks a bit flat. You know, there's all sorts happening here. Oh, check it out. That sign has already blown off into the road. Brilliant. That was effective, wasn't it? That's going to blow away. Oh, check it out. Excellent. Yeah, they're going up and down doing something. I don't quite know what it's all about myself. I'm no expert. Oh, the blind. There we go.
So this afternoon, of course, I've got plenty to be getting on with. I've got a package, and I believe I know who that's from. So we'll have a look at, we'll have a look at that in a second. I'm just gonna have a little sit down, a little chill, and get myself sorted here.
I'm just doing a little Amazon order, guys. I promised someone that owns a Galaxy S3 Mini that I'd order them a battery, because they didn't know what to order and stuff, so I've got that in my basket, as well as two of these green hard drive archive boxes. These are really cool. You can basically put your 3.5 inch drives in there, and they come with a label. I'm going to start archiving, and I've got two of these already, but I want two more. Going with the archival theme, I've got a nice 3.5 inch/2.5 inch USB 3.0 hard drive dock, finally. I know Will will be proud of me for that. And I have another one of these. Where is it? It's here. Another one of these Patriot USB 3.0 16 gig USB drives, because I told Christian wants a UniBeast pen drive, and I said I'd make it for him because he doesn't have a Mac, and I'll send it over. It's the least I can do. I'm just trying to think if there's anything else I need to order. There's always little things that you need to get, but I'm trying to think that, you know, there's got to be a cable or something. I think I'm relatively okay. I knew I needed to get this stuff, but there was something. Oh, come on, Tom. Ah, I tell you what, I'll just order it. Proceed to checkout. I can always just order again if I need something else. So it turns out, guys, that Keith sent me a black, nice and long, nice and thin Ethernet cable to use with my test setup, which is really, really nice of him. I think that's so nice of him. Keith was the one that donated the 5450 and the Firewire card last week, so that was great. I'm gonna shoot him an email off. I'm gonna have to reconnect my Mac Pro very soon, in the next hour or so. But the Hackintosh is going great. I had a couple of freezes this morning, but it seems to be great now. So I'm not too sure. I need to delve into the freezes, but you know, naturally, that's what you get. I'm gonna re-cable tie my test setup to incorporate the Ethernet cable, but before I do any of that, I need lunch, guys. I'm starving, really hungry. Cranberry juice, lovely, have a glass of that.
So yeah, plenty to be getting on with. But yeah, massive thanks to Keith. I'll have to shoot him an email when I hook my Mac Pro back up, because I haven't got my emails set up on my power hack yet. Oh, well, I have, but I'd rather do it on my Mac Pro. Ah, the house phone's ringing. Oh, anyway, back to what I was saying. This camera is working out... socks everywhere. This camera is working out really well for vlogging. I'm really enjoying using it. It's so nice. I just hope I'm getting everything in frame and stuff. There is a sort of camcorder-style grip that you can get for this camera, which looks really good. And considering how small this camera is... hang on a second. Just getting myself positioned here. Considering how small this camera is, I don't think it'll add much bulk. It's like a camcorder grippy type thing with a screen, but I'm not sure how much that would affect the battery life. Although I'm not too sure what the battery life is anyway. Stunning. But yeah. Oh. I'm gonna have to make myself something proper. I can't just munch on things. So it's getting closer and closer to work time, and I'm very happy because I've made my DVDs. The cover isn't totally done yet, as you can tell. It's very blank, but I've made one DVD. This is the rough cut, so this is the point where they tell me exactly what they want in terms of cover. I also haven't received the photo of the bride and groom for the DVD cover, and I have not printed the disc. Unfortunately, I did want to do a disc printing demo. It's tonight. I've got to give them this DVD. So it's just a blank light scribe disc at the moment, but it looks okay. It looks okay blank, thank God. You know, at least it hasn't got DVD-R written on it or whatever. My Mac Pro is being very fussy with light scribe, which is a pain, but I'm gonna give it one more crack now and see if I can get something on the label. Well, guys, I made it to work. I've had quite... the day has been just kind of upside down for me and really, really busy. So I haven't been able to document that much. The fact that they were digging up the road and that was okay for me to walk to work because they'd already left by the time I wanted to go to work. So that was really, really handy. So yeah, I've got a normal shift here tonight. I'll be out of here around 9:45, showing two films, San Andreas and Tomorrowland. One in screen one, one in screen two. Simple night. I'm absolutely boiling because I walked up. And I was wearing my jumper and I just broke out into a bit of a sweat, but everything is good. Auditorium 2 is looking a little bit empty, but there's probably some people in Auditorium 1.
What is up, everyone? It is Friday. I made the fatal error of leaving my camera switched on, and I think maybe recording, I don't know, I haven't checked yet, in my pocket. So I ran out of battery. I think the last update I gave you was maybe Wednesday, but it's Friday today. Oh, it could have been Tuesday, the last update I gave you, I can't even remember. But yeah, I've had a busy couple of days down the studio and stuff. I was hoping to take the bloody camera and, you know, record a few things and that, but I didn't have a USB cable with me and I haven't been home, so... it's been a bit tricky, but I've got some cool things to show you today, so let's take a little look. So the camera's still got low battery, so I'm gonna be quick. As you can see, they are tarmacking the road, so that's pretty cool. They've been working on that today. I had a couple of deliveries through. I have got, where is it? Where is that? Ah, down here, I have got a pen drive, another one of these Patriot drives. That's for Christian. I'm going to be making him a Hackintosh drive. Can't remember if I mentioned that or not. I received delivery of this S3 mini battery that I got for someone, and also this hard drive dock, which is pretty cool. So I'm going to be making a video on this 3.5-inch USB 3.0 docking station. And I do have a carrier bag of random bits and bobs from my auntie. And let's see what's in here. Stuff that she was clearing out. We have what looks to be like a wireless kind of keyboard or something. This is cool. It takes batteries. It's got a big infrared thing on the back. Wow, this is interesting. I have no idea what this is. It's got, is that for the TV? It almost looks for the TV because it's got like TV buttons on it.
Not too sure what that is. Let me get a light on, guys, just in case the footage doesn't come out that great. As you can see, my efforts of tidying my room have already pretty much turned to crap. What else do we have? Ah, awesome. Check this out, guys. Loads of CDs. A big spindle of CDs. Massively handy. There's a couple of different types here by the looks of it. Let's have a little look. What's underneath? And they are DVDs. So I've got a few DVDs and a few CDs. I say a few, that's quite a lot. That is awesome. Wicked stuff. It's always good when some people have a clear out. We have a little green wireless mouse. Logitech, nice. Wonder if the receiver's in here. Doubtful. What's this? A USB mouse, looks fairly standard. I will be keeping a hold of this because I don't have many. And what's left? No receiver for that mouse, unfortunately. But we have a couple of discs here. Digimon? What is this? That's worth sticking in the computer and having a look. Is it a game or what? Wow. Okay, cool. And Pepsi, episode 1. Are these like demo discs or something? I have no idea, guys. Let's stick this Digimon thing in the computer and see what it does. This is really old, guys. At Cinemas Everywhere, February 6th. At least I think this is really old, unless Digimon is coming back. Is it making a comeback or what? It's making quite a racket and shaking the house when they do various things, guys. Okay, so that's spinning up. What is happening? Anything? This disc is making such a weird noise spinning. It's a Windows disc, guys. It's all .exe. So it's something pretty entertaining. awesome stuff. So a couple of bits and bobs here. It's always handy when people are clearing out. Those CDs and DVDs are the most handy things. Don't think I'll keep this. Don't know what this is all about. Nice feeling keys though. I'll definitely keep the mouse, USB, that'll be handy.
So guys, I'm a little bit tired today. I was down the studio yesterday and stuff doing some drum tracks. I really wanted to take you everywhere this week with a vlog. I'm gutted that I ran out of battery. I'm going to plug the camera in now and see if I recorded a clip in my pocket. I can just imagine like an hour long clip in my pocket.
Check it out, guys. Painting the road. And this is fast progress. These guys are faster than the guys putting the gas line in. Definitely faster. They're actually pretty damn speedy. As you can see, they're painting slow on the road at the moment. It says Arav slow. Arav is slow in Welsh, in case anyone's wondering. But yeah, they're doing really well. And they got a little fiery thing down there on the back of that lorry. I actually have no idea what that's for.
What up, guys? It is Sunday. Don't know when the last vlog update I gave you guys was. My week, put it this way, right? I had all these plans planned out for my week off. I knew exactly what I was going to do. But my week has gone balmy. Nothing has gone correct. But it's cool because I've still worked on all the stuff I wanted to work on. So that's great. I'm really happy. I'm looking at my post-it notes and I've still got loads marked down here. But, ooh, actually I can get rid of one of them. Bye-bye. Yeah. But this week has been a bit upside down, and the vlog has not been nearly as detailed as I've wanted it to be, but today is Sunday and it is my day to work on Power Hack Part 5. I've been working on it for a couple of hours already, still on the intro. I finally settled with an intro that I like. It's currently around 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I've got the rest of the day. I reckon I'm gonna get it done today. I really, really hope so.
4:45, guys, and I am enjoying I'm enjoying editing and creating part 5. I am pretty much on the home stretch to finishing it, I believe. I think I'll finish it today, which will be great. I could work on it a little bit tomorrow because, you know, it won't be live until tomorrow night, but I would love to get it done today.
That is the goal. So I'm currently rendering it. I'm up to 16 minutes of work. This isn't going to be a crazy long video. I'd say half an hour at the absolute maximum, but it's probably going to be 20 to 25 minutes. I'm very pleased so far. I've got to the end of the benchmarks for the discs, and now it's time to benchmark graphics and see what that's like. And yeah, basically, I'll show you how I'm working, how the workflow is going. So here is my project, and I'm just rendering the whole thing at the moment because there were a few cross dissolves and stuff that needed rendering. I've got my intro here. This is all intro slash... Actually, what have we got here? Intro, talk about specs and boot up is all here. And benchmarks is here, which is cool. This is disc benchmark, so talking a lot about the discs. Of course, I've got all my media over here. Most of it is voiceovers at the moment, and we have clips from previous parts that I am using for... of course, the intro and little bits of B-roll and stuff. And then we have screenshots that are all coming from the Hackintosh. Now, the Hackintosh is over here, and it keeps going to sleep every now and again when I'm working on my project. But there it is. There is the Hackintosh sitting there. I've got my camera here for what I need to use my camera for. But it is just a messy, very simple workbench that I've got going. Nothing crazy to make part five. Just got the Hackintosh here. I'll just type in my password really quickly. As you can see, the last file is the QuickTime recording I did for the Blackmagic disk speed test, which is all good. And yeah, it makes it really easy because I'm editing in real time. I'm not getting a whole pool of footage and then trying to trawl through it. This is a real-time edit, which makes it quicker, which is great. I started from the ground up today, guys, basically. I've done a lot with part five in the past, but none of it was really any good. Of course, I've got my mic hanging here, which I use for all of my voiceovers. It's great. All I do with the Blue Snowball is add quite a hefty high-pass filter onto it. But with a gradual curve ranging from 80 hertz to 140 hertz, and I stick a standard compressor on it from Final Cut, and I don't change any of the settings. The default settings for the compressor are fine. So here we are in the making of part five. Like I say, next thing I've got to do is graphics benchmarks. So guys, I'm currently filming my Heaven benchmark. Of course, I'm using the camera instead of screen recording because the using screen recording doing a benchmark will dramatically decrease the benchmark, of course. But here it is, filming that. It is looking awesome. Of course, we can talk because I'll be doing a voiceover. I won't be using the audio from the camera. But man, this looks so nice on the 960. Just working on a little bit of a Mac Pro restart, guys. I had to do this a couple of times with the other big video editing projects that I've done. It just gets a little overwhelmed. It could be a RAM thing, to be honest, which is quite intriguing because I stated how 8 gigs is plenty for me in this very video that I'm editing. But I do restart my system every now and again, and then I load Final Cut back up and I get quicker performance. So it is currently 1733. I can work on this until as late as I want, but I don't really want to work on it later than sort of 8 o'clock. So I hope to be done by then. That would be really, really cool. I am 18 minutes into the video, and I've got to the end of the benchmark, so it's just conclusions and stuff left. Excuse me, everyone. I don't know why I've started sneezing now, but anyway, it's just conclusions left. It's just wait and see how the video evolves. I haven't storyboarded it or anything like that. It's literally evolving straight out of my mind as stuff's going down on the video, so I'm happy with that. All right, guys, 5 to 8 on a Sunday evening. I didn't factor in for dinner as usual, so for the last hour or so, I've been downstairs eating dinner and stuff, just having a little break. My video is very, very close to being complete. All of the audio is done. It is 25 minutes long. All I've got to do is fill up the ending with a few flashbacks from the highlights of the series in terms of video clips and do a couple of little text things, and I will be done. This is how the timeline is looking. I've edited a video up to 23 minutes odd, and I've just got another 2 minutes to fill. So I'm very, very happy with the way this video has turned out. Absolutely awesome, awesome stuff. Yeah. It's going to be great. I think you guys are going to love it. At 20 past 8, I am ready
for the final preview. I preview in Final Cut, as you guys know, so I'm just doing the final render now, rendering the last few bits, and it is time for me to watch through the whole thing and correct anything that is incorrect. Part 5 done and uploading. Uploading, it's exported and everything. 10 to 10 and I am beyond tired. Like, seriously tired. But I'm really happy with what I've managed to do. Really, really happy, actually. I've got to say goodnight, guys. Tomorrow I'm in work. I'll hopefully take you to work. And tomorrow I'm hopefully rigging up so I can show you some cool things. What is up, everyone? It is Monday. Monday afternoon, more specifically, 14:09. And I went to work this morning. And I'm just going to stop promising that I'm rigging up and testing ready for a show because it didn't happen again. It's happening next Monday now. It's really hard to find time to do stuff in work because the way the place is run, you know, if you've got to do something specific at that time, you've got to do it. And me wanting to do my own stuff, like test the rig and stuff, has to wait until I've got actual freedom to do it. So I'm currently just watching Will's vlog. I've started watching Will's vlog. I am enjoying watching it, so I'm going to relax, watch this, I'm going to maybe get some food with it, and then I've got the unboxing of, where is it and what is it called? This thing, here we are, oh crap, this is the USB 3.0 SATA HDD docking station by Inatech, here it is, finally. Gonna be unboxing that. I need that. It'll be very, very handy. I will unbox that and it'll be tomorrow's video. I knew the vlog was gonna be tomorrow's video, but I've got to film a little bit more for you guys because I haven't really filmed much. Oh man. And I'm gonna start editing this vlog today as well, just to see what it's like and maybe erase my SD card and stuff if I can figure out how to do that, because I wasted like an hour or two on this SD card with the camera going off in my pocket, as you guys know. That was a complete train wreck, but pretty hilarious. Yet another video done and exporting. Thumbnail made. I've actually, I'm just kind of halfway through listening to some Madonna, guys, believe it or not. The Madonna Greatest Hits album. And I can't play any of it now, but there's a track by Madonna called 4 Minutes. It was a big deal a few years ago, but you know, now nobody really hears it, I guess. And it's got this annoying thing with my sub, and I get a couple of tracks like this. The sub sounds like ever so slightly out of tune, just like a quarter of a semitone out of tune. And it's so weird, like the bass notes, because instead of like a traditional like electronic kick drum that you get in like dancey type music, it's more of a bass note, and it sounds out of tune when you listen to the track in relevance to the rest of the track. It's so odd. Certain subwoofers are like that, or it could be the track, I don't know. It's just really weird and it really irritates me. But yeah, back on topic. I've made a video about the little hard drive dock, and here it is. I don't know why I'm in a Madonna mood. It's weird, you know, the various things that you listen to like that, I don't know, whatever. Guys, I am desperate beyond belief for a haircut. My mum cuts my hair, so it'd be really cool if she comes back today in time for a haircut before I go to work, but she probably won't, considering I'll be going to work around 6:30. But I do have a new bike. I picked up a new bike secondhand, or my dad picked it up for me. And I am really, really... That's a noise I don't hear very often, a Facebook notification. Anyway, I am really looking forward to testing it out, so I'm going to ride it to work and back tonight. It's just your basic mountain bike from the 90s, but I'm really liking it. Simple, simple. It's awesome as well. It's green in that. I'll show you tonight. I might actually mount the handlebar mount on my bike. I will probably do that. That'll be a good bit of fun to do and cycle to work. But yeah, it's all good. Where am I going with this clip? Oh, right, yeah. So I've just edited that video and done everything. It is 15:38, so I've accomplished quite a lot today. I'm pretty happy. I need to eat. I've had one slice of toast all day. So, yeah. Oh, and I enjoyed Will's vlog. That was awesome. I commented saying, do more vlogs, Will, or something along those lines. So, all is well. And just after recording that clip, my mum phoned me to inform me that she will not be home before work. So, I'm going to have a haircut tomorrow, I think. I will definitely have time to have one tomorrow, as long as she's got time. So, what I've decided to do this afternoon, guys, considering I've got the whole afternoon to myself, well, I say the whole afternoon, I've got about 2.5 hours until I have to go to work. So that's excellent time to have some food, because obviously I'll have to have dinner as well before work. So I'm going to wait a little bit more before eating maybe. And then if I have like loads of food, that'll kind of count as lunch and dinner maybe. Because I've got my new bike, like I was telling you guys, I'm going to try out the bicycle mount, which is going to be so awesome. As you guys know, Christian donated this along with this camera. And couple that with the housing that I have here, and that will make an awesome, awesome biking experience with this camera, hopefully. I think it'll be really cool. I'll try it out today on my way to work and see what it looks like. And I'll show you, of course, the process of putting it on the bike as well, and you can take a look at my bike.
Didn't actually get a chance to unbox this in the video. Sorry about the crappy camera work for a second, guys. Come on. Whoa, pointing the camera completely at the wrong bit. There we go. Okay, wow. So here it is, basic. Nothing too crazy. It's basically a camera mount there and a handlebar mount there. Easy stuff. I should be able to figure out how to do that quite easily. I need an Allen key by the looks of it. Little things like this in life sent to try us, guys. I've had one missing Allen key on my set of Allen keys for forever, for as long as I can remember. And the size that this takes is the size that I'm missing, so I'm gonna have to hunt for Allen keys.
So I've got the trusty peak cap on, guys, and I am ready to go. And oh crap, I've forgotten half the shit I need to put this on the handlebars. No point taking my Allen keys down, I don't have the right size. So I'm gonna have to find some Allen keys. I know my dad's garage is gonna be locked, and I'm not sure how where the keys are or anything, because whenever I want anything, he's here. So I'm gonna start by putting shoes on. I should really feed myself before doing this, because I may get frustrated if I can't find an Allen key. Ah, something's beeping down here. What have we got? Dishwasher is complete. That doesn't normally beep repetitively. Ah, that makes sense. The washing machine is also on. Cool. Washing machine off. Dishwasher off. Open that up so that it dries, even though it's nearly dry. Yeah, I need to find Allen keys. I'm gonna have a quick scout around the house to see if there's any in here, guys. Today is a good day. I'm feeling good today. I found one random Allen key in the toolbox in the cupboard under the stairs, and it fits. So that is obviously my missing Allen key, which is great. And this was the first place I looked before even bothering to look anywhere else. And there's literally nothing much of any use in this toolbox. Only that Allen key, so that was a great find. Only slight annoyances. Oh, I've just closed it. Cool, even that annoyance was out of the way. So that was in there. Let's put that back there and pick that up because I dropped that. Job done, guys. So I am now ready. Ah, that's an awesome feeling. So I get to show you guys my new bike as well. I'm really pleased. Basically, I wanted a super simple bike because I was getting annoyed with my front suspension on my mountain bike. It absorbs all your energy, in my opinion. And I wanted just a nice, simple, not too many gears. Let's put all this in my pocket. Put that there. Put these there. And at the same time, guys, I can actually use my bike mount. Actually, so here it is. What a machine. Okay, let's take a look. So this is how it's looking at the moment, guys. As you can see, it's awesome. Nice rally, should do me really well. Nice big brake levers, which is much better than my old bike. On the handlebars, as you can see here, we've got kind of limited space because of the gear shifts. So I'm gonna have to put it somewhere. I also need space for my bike light mounts. But that shouldn't be a problem. We should be able to fit everything on with ease, hopefully. So what happens is you've got this bike mount and it's kind of loose fitting. If I just do this as an example. There we go. As you can see, it doesn't tighten or anything like that. You basically use these rubber grommets to fill in the space. So I assume you find a good combination of these that work for you by test fitting them first, and then you can peel off the self-adhesive at the back and stick them permanently. There we have it, folks. I'm fully set up and ready to go. That is where the camera will sit. I've got it as flat as I could. Looks absolutely awesome. I've just got the case on there for illustration purposes only.
two front lights, and of course, naturally, a fully very safe and properly mounted backlight as well, which is all good. So I'm ready to hit the road on my new bike.
So just a crazy test clip up the garden, guys. I'm going to slam this into the computer right now and take a look because I'm intrigued as to what it looks like. It's going to be shaky as hell because it's really difficult to ride up that garden path, of course. But really pleased with the fact that that mount fits on my rather small handlebars with the with my bike light mount. So that's really good. Yeah, I'm going to slam this in right now. And let's take a look.
Well, guys, I've just checked that out and it looks awesome. Can't wait to do a proper bike ride. Of course, the audio isn't the greatest because, you know, the bike is vibrating and it's shaking through the camera and stuff. But it kind of got me thinking about maybe I could either voice over. If I want to chat to you guys in the future, I could either voice over. But because that won't be in context, I could do like a bike journey and speed it up and put some music there, or I could do entire videos in the future. I've been wanting to upload some of my music to YouTube for a while now, and I didn't know what to put in the video, you know, because I didn't just want to upload an audio track. So I could do like certain journeys that I do on my bike and that would be really cool. And the other option is for me to look into getting a cheap little secondhand Zoom recorder that I can keep in my pocket and get a little lav mic and clip it here. So if I want to vlog while cycling, I'll take the video from this camera and just chat to the camera using this lav mic. You know, I'd obviously have to be on a cycle path or something. You couldn't do it if I was cycling on the pavement or on the road. But yeah, I could just get a little lav mic and hopefully that would be good enough with the wind and everything. I could just chat to you guys and then sync it up in post. That would be really cool. Obviously a little bit more work, but let me know what you think, guys. Or if you think the cycling thing is totally lame, but I think it is awesome. Another cool thing is, as well, I can put the camera on the other way around and tilt the mount up so that I can film myself while I'm cycling. It'll be a little bit of an up-the-nose shot, but from what I can eyeball from the handlebars, it'll be more of a sort of maybe that kind of orientation, so I'll be looking forward there, I don't know. But of course the audio, again, may be a little issue. That's the only one tiny downfall with this camera. You have to put it in its waterproof enclosure in order to attach it to a tripod. I wish there was like a tripod mount on the bottom already, but this camera is incredible. Christian is such a legend, and for vlogging, I think it's awesome.
Ah, time to get some grub, guys. My stomach is physically hurting because I am so hungry. One slice of toast and the time is 18 minutes past 5, that is atrocious. One slight thing, I spent all day on the computer yesterday, and I am so pleased that I have improved my setup to the point where it is very comfortable to use, but I may have to go that one step further somehow because, oh, sirens, because I do notice, let's have a little sit here for a second, I do notice slight pains. Now, I'm not going to go as far as to say that it's RSI or anything, although it is repetitive strain that has caused the pain. It's more like RSP, repetitive strain pain. It's not an injury because, you know, I'm not injured yet, or I suppose over the long term I would be. But at this moment in time, if you look at your hand, you've got these bones that go down that connect your fingers to your wrists, and you can see them if you move your fingers. And the one that I have for this finger, for some reason, this finger that doesn't really have a purpose at all, on its own anyway, only collectively as your hand. I mean, this is your little finger, this is your pointing finger, this is your fuck you finger, you know. This one,
is the bone is really hurting. It's like pushing my skin. It's something to do with my mouse. And it pushes my skin and it is really hurting. So I don't know whether it's the level of my arm and whether I need to adjust my chair, because you can never prove what causes this kind of thing. You've just got to try different things and figure it out for yourself. But luckily, the old neck pains and stuff that I was getting, which are far more worrying, have totally subsided since I did my ultimate desk setup project. And I guess it is rare that I would spend 11 hours straight at the computer. That was crazy yesterday, you know, really, really crazy. Or it wasn't even 11 hours, was it? It was a bit less than that. But I spent a lot of time on the computer today as well. And the hand is annoying. And the more I think about it, it is because I do believe that a lot of the RSI stuff is in here. The more that I think about it, the more that my hand begins to ache, if that makes sense. Not the pain, it doesn't increase pain. It just like, you know, if something cringes you, if something goes through you, like, I don't like ripping paper. That really, really cringes me. It goes through me. And it makes the ends of my fingers feel horrible. It's hard to explain. Everyone's got their stuff. It's kind of like that. It's like a dull, aching feeling that if you just think about something else, it'll eventually go away. But if you acknowledge the fact that it's gone away, then it'll come back. But yeah, that's just a little something, guys. Probably I'm talking total bollocks as usual, but that's just a little something that I thought I'd mention. To kick off the food, I know we have packets of crisps, so I'm going to have one of those. And I don't know what I'm going to make for food. I know I've got some bacon and stuff, so let's have a look. Cracking stuff, guys. Just turn the radio off. Just giving this another little test out for my dad. It's a lovely little vintage radio. Sounds absolutely brilliant. Of course, I can't turn it up too much because the copyright and all that. Anyway, there we have it. Looking good. Let's do that. Let's do that. Job done. I'm happy.
El Capitan? El Capitan? El Capitan? No, I don't know how to pronounce it at the moment, but I will get there. I've just tuned into WWDC, guys. But I'm not going to be able to watch it. I'm going to have a gap between watching it. I'll probably have a gap of about 20 minutes that I'll miss, but I can continue watching it at work.
Here it is. Got it streaming there. It'll be cool to chill here all night, but no can do, I'm afraid.
Showtime, folks. Of course, unlocking the door would help. Not sure what the audio is like when I use this case, by the way. Okay. I will see you guys on the other side. Thank you.
Oh, well, 15 minutes, guys, not too bad at all. 15 minutes including cycling and me working my way through work to come back out the back door to collect my bike. Awesome stuff. Rad cycle, new bike is great. I'm gonna take a look at this footage and see what it looks like. Work's all done and dusted, guys. It's been a crazy evening. I'll talk to you more about it later or tomorrow. But for now, let's enjoy the cycle home and probably a slightly altered route. Thank you.
So as you guys can tell, the cycling footage comes out really, really well. And due to the length of this video, I think I've got to stop it here. A massive thanks for following me over the past couple of weeks, guys. I know my week off wasn't as jam-packed as we all initially thought it was going to be. It was jam-packed for me, but nothing much interesting to film. And I did have that massive disaster with the camera in my pocket, which was hilarious. So I'm now much more used to using this camera, and the next vlog will be much better. None of the audio issues where I had the camera in the casing and all that stuff. And the cycle home from work, the entire mount had slipped down the handlebars a little bit. I have now sorted that, so you may have noticed that the cycle to work was captured a lot better by the camera with lots less jittery motion and stuff. But anyway, massive thank you for watching my vlog, everyone. Let me know, as usual, if you made it to the end. I thoroughly enjoy making these videos, and sorry that I dragged it out a little bit and there was a delay before uploading the vlog, but naturally, as you saw, I didn't have enough footage from the first week. But anyway, again, massive thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you've enjoyed, and I will see you all in the next video.